Good morning, I'm Dan Flack, Sales Director at Red 96. This morning I'm going to give a demonstration on how to remove a screen box on a RubbleMaster RM90 Go. First of all, we take a walk around the machine to get us started. Here on the left hand side of the machine, we have the remote that operates the up and down function on the screen box. Is what we do is we lower the machine down to the floor. The most important part of this is making sure the machine is level and these 4 feet touch the floor. You can lower the front ones up and down on these pins. Once the machine is level, we then remove our finger from lowering the machine on the rams and re-hip, and we simply push these here out. We then take a 27mm spanner and we tighten these or move the rams up. The point that the hooks are clear of the locating pins, we're done. We do the other side. Now that your pins are out of the way, our next move is to switch off the machine and isolate the machine. Always make sure you isolate the machine at this point. Here we have all the electrics that connect the screen box to the front of the crusher. You remove this cap, put in the dummy plug. And remove the electrics here. Our next stage, if you look down here, we have two hydraulic connectors. These need to be removed.
They're on opposite threads, so you can't get them mixed up.
Then put on the blanking caps. Our next job is to remove these pins. Now you may find if the machine isn't completely square, we may need to start the machine and just nudge one side slightly. We'll check the other side quickly now. As you can see, this pin's a little bit tight, so we're just going to nudge the machine forward slightly just to release that pin. Turn our tracking feature on. Give this a slight nudge. Now, this pin's free. Now that we have everything on the machine disconnected, we're ready to track the machine away from the screen. How you remove a screen box from a RubbleMaster RM90 Go.